Of questions, Your Honor, on the assumption that we will be granted to continue at tomorrow's hearing, Your Honor.
Proceed.
All right. Thank you, Your Honor. Good afternoon, Madam Secretary.
Good afternoon, sir.
It's nice to see you around.
Same here.
Now, once upon a time, this representation was also a Secretary of Justice, the department you are now handling. And I have gone over the powers and prerogatives of the Secretary pursuant to the administrative code that you have mentioned.
Yes, sir.
I did not see in there any power or function granted to the Secretary to review, much less reverse, any decision of the Supreme Court. Do you agree with me?
Yes, Your Honor, definitely not. No such power.
Yes. And this is because of the hierarchy in our governmental setup, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor.
Insofar as the Judicial Department is concerned, the head is the Supreme Court, and on top of that is the Chief Justice.
Yes, Your Honor.
Now,
yes, sir.
Do you know of any branch of the government that can go deep by way of constitutional function into examining the decisions or orders of the Supreme Court?
If we're talking about decisions of the Supreme Court,
go ahead, please.
Then it's only the Supreme Court.
So there is no governmental function or machinery that can dig deeper into the wisdom, validity, and correctness or constitutionality of any decision of the Supreme Court?
Yes, in the exercise of its judicial review.
All right. Now, is there any function allotted to the executive department whereby it can review, even in a minor sense, the decision or orders of the Honorable Supreme Court?
Reviewing the decisions and orders of the Supreme Court? Also none, because the Supreme Court is...
And you must agree with me that this is embodied in several decisions already, like the Borromeo, the Malabang versus Court of Appeals case, whereby a party litigant lost his case in Negros, went to the Court of Appeals. The decision was also in favor of his opponent, went to the Supreme Court, and it was denied. Filed the motion for reconsideration, the motion is denied. So what he did was to go to the office of the president and filed an administrative case against the members of the Supreme Court. And that was dismissed by the Supreme Court. Do you recall that case?
Well, I don't exactly recall that case, The principle involved, I'm familiar with.
All right. And there was a dictum in there stating that there is no authority or governmental setup in our system of government, not even the office of the president can review, much less reverse, any decision of the Supreme Court. Am I right?
Yes, Your Honor, in the exercise of this
You recognize
review.
That?
Yes, Your Honor.
In the governmental setup, necessarily the Supreme Court is higher than any of the departments of the executive department.
The judiciary, the Supreme Court, is a co-equal branch.
Yeah, insofar as the departments are concerned, right?
Yes, Your Honor.
But how, I'm referring to the other cabinet, the cabinet of the president, or the departments under the president, are they co-equal with this? Is that what you wanted to tell us?
Well, the departments or the executive offices under the office of the president, they all form part of the executive department.
Correct.
So they have the executive department, all executive officers have their respective powers and prerogatives in the exercise of the executive power, and the executive branch of government happens to be a co-equal branch of government.
And in the distribution of powers under the Constitution, it is not the cabinet member or the department officials that are on level with the judiciary, is it not?
It is the president or
the chief executive.
The officers under the executive department, or specifically the cabinet secretaries, they are considered the alter egos
right.
of the president.
Right. Now, if that is so, why could there be a dispute relative to the validity of the resolution of the Honorable Supreme Court in connection with the issuance of hold order by a secretary of the department, or secretary of the president?
There is an issue because of the propriety of the TRO. As I explained earlier, responding to the question of the Honorable Presiding Officer, we are questioning the propriety of the TRO because it violates, or it went against, or goes against the very essence of a TRO.
And after your challenge against the TRO had been resolved, is there any alternative left to the to any member of the cabinet to disobey the order ruling of the Supreme Court, irrespective of the nobility of purpose on the part of the secretary?
Yes, if there is a final ruling on the issue of the validity of the TRO, then we will have no choice but to adhere to the TRO, because that would be a final ruling of the Supreme Court, and we cannot reverse the Supreme Court on that matter.
I understand that in this case there was a ruling already insofar as the TRO is concerned, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor, that was November 18.
Yes, and that had never been amended, much less repealed or revoked as of this time, is it not?
No, Your Honor, because it denied precisely the motion to lift and or motion for reconsideration of the November 15, 2011 TRO.
And the motion to lift was denied?
The motion to lift was denied resolution of November 18.
And it means, to us, it means therefore that the TRO stands as it is.
As of November 18, it was not yet clear because of the dispute on the exact interpretation, the import of the TRO, whether it was already considered effective on account of the non-compliance by petitioners with condition number 2. Nalaman po natin.
I'm sorry, Mr. Madam Secretary. Go ahead,
Opo,
please.
As of November 18, hindi pa ho klaro yun na effective na yung TRO. Wala pa nga ho silang pinalabas any confirmation, any order, any ruling na yes, there had been compliance already with the conditions of the TRO. Sa pagkakaalam ko po, kailangan ng separate order or any clarification from the Supreme Court doon sa compliance. And it is only when there has been a confirmation of the full compliance and with the conditions na pwede na nating sabihin na naging effective na po yung TRO.
I know that you had been a practitioner of note before entering the government. Is that right?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And you must have been continuously in appellate practice.
Well, I have some exposure to appellate practice. Yeah.
You knew that the Supreme Court acts in bank and also in a division.
Yes, po.
And
yes,
the decisions of the court, Supreme Court, whether in bank or in division, must be a majority decision.
Yes, sir.
It is in its entirety the responsibility of all the members who participated therein, not a particular member, not even solely by the ponente.
Yes, sir.
All right. Now, in this particular instance, there is a statement in here, and may I be allowed to read it for your benefit. Respondent betrayed public trust through his partiality in granting a temporary restraining order in favor of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo. My understanding of this particular impeachment article is that it was the Honorable Chief Corona who issued the restraining order. Is that correct? Or do you agree with that based on the allegation of this impeachment complaint?
Well, as crafted, so, it seems to be the connotation, but it's actually referring to the TRO as issued.
Yes, and that particular TRO issued was not solely issued only by the Chief Justice. In fact, he has no participation in the issue once thereof.
Well, he concurred in the issuance of the TRO because he was one of the 8 members who voted in favor of the issuance of the TRO in November 15.
Could you give us an explanation as to why the charges were merely leveled against the Chief Justice, notwithstanding the fact that there would have been no TRO had there been no concurrence of the majority of the court?
Well, the allegation is with respect to partiality. Now, betrayal of public trust because of the partiality on the part of the respondent in issuing the TRO, which had the effect of aiding the former president to leave the country and escape prosecution.
I have not gone that far yet. My only question is, since this TRO, according to you, was granted by the Supreme Court acting in bank, and there were 8 justices who participated therein. In fact, there is an allegation that the rest of the other members of the Supreme Court conspired and confederated with the Chief Justice in issuing this TRO. Do you subscribe to that view, or may we hear your comment in connection therewith?
Objection, Mr. President.
What is question the basis
misleading.
Of, what's the
there's
basis
no,
of,
there's no admission.
What, the, what of, is the basis no, of the objection?
Yes, the question is predicated on the claim that there is conspiracy among the,
well, a while
the
ago,
justices. Yes,
Your Honor, please.
So I object to that because there's no such allegation.
I'm not saying
it of conspiracy, nor is there any statement by the witness, but that there was conspiracy.
I have not gone that far, Your Honor. I just predicated my question on your admission to the question, to the clarificatory questions made by the Honorable Senator a while ago, that the 8 or the other members conspired with the Chief Justice that enabled the Chief Justice to issue this alleged questionable restraining order.
So the question, Mr. President, I understand therefore that the question is hypothetical. In other words, because there's no admission of
conspiracy.
We submit,
Your Honor.
Wait a minute. The question is, did the counsel for the member of the prosecution asserted that the respondent conspired with other members of the court to issue the TRO? Is that
Your Honor.
Asserted.
Yes, Your Honor.
It was asserted by whom?
By the Honorable Congressman Dasa.
All right. Let us appeal to the record, to be fair.
There was a question, Your Honor.
Stenographer, will you kindly check the questioning by the gentleman from Samar to find out whether he used the word conspired or conspiracy? Mm-hmm. So in order to be fair, all these things are recorded, so...
I'll just withdraw the question, if the court so allows, Your Honor, so that we can move a little further. I'll reform the question.
All right.
All right.
You want to withdraw and reform your question?
Yes, Your Honor. Now, there is also mentioned in here that the actuation of the Honorable Justice Corona was in order to give the former president the opportunity to escape prosecution.
That's in the Article 7.
Uh-oh. Do you subscribe to that to this statement appearing in here? Or you have doubts also?
I subscribe.
All right.
To that allegation.
All right. In other words, there is really the desire on the part of Justice Corona to allow the escape of the GMA.
From my own appreciation of what happened, the developments, actions, what I read in the opinions, etc., yes.
So this is not based on your personal opinion?
My own observations, based on, again, as I said, my appreciation of the attendant facts and circumstances, and based on the pleadings, the orders, the disclosures, revelations in the dissenting opinion.
But
and Your Honors, also because, well, when in fact, in the issuance itself, of the TRO. So it was November 15, and then we were given only very limited period to file a comment, only in 3 days, due on November 18. And then they set the oral arguments for November 22. That's not common, sir. Normally, the respondents are given a period of 10 days to file a comment, and then after which, if the court so desires, we'll set the case for oral arguments. Right. Now, very limited period, and then immediately oral arguments for November 22. Now, if they intended to get the comment from us in just in 3 days, and they intended to hear us out in that oral arguments on November 22, why issue the TRO on November 15?
So that is your conclusion?
Yes, Your Honor.
On the basis, according to you, of the documents you have read?
Documents and my understanding, and I'm a student of law.
Would you say that there was conspiracy among the members of the Supreme Court that enables the grant of the restraining order? Conspiracy is a pasty buck, and the liability of one is the liability of all. That's why I asked this question. Why is the impeachment complaint only gravitate or centers on the Chief Justice, excluding the other conspirators?
Because
Mr. President,
yes.
I object to the question as argumentative.
No, let the Secretary of Justice answer. It's not argumentative. It's just asking whether she knows, as a matter of fact, that there was conspiracy.
If the question is demanding for a categorical answer on my part?
Certainly, yes.
Conspiracy?
Yes.
The conspiracy, because they issued the questionable TRO. Well, the Chief Justice is only one vote, of course, when it comes to decisions. There are other things. There are other functions and duties and powers of the Chief Justice as primus inter pares.
But that's not my question to you, Madam Secretary. My question to you is, this restraining order could not have come into effect were it not for the fact that a majority of the court in bank decided to grant the same. Am I right?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. It could not have been possible by the signature merely of Chief Justice Corona, is it not?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And since the actual result is there was a restraining order issued by the court, the responsibility is supposed to be shouldered by all the signatories to that resolution granting the restraining order. Or you have a different view?
If we talk only about the voting and the position with respect to the propriety of the TRO, with 8 of them concurring that TRO at the time was proper in their view, or that's their position as the majority, then yes.
Thank you. I noticed that you have laid very heavy an emphasis on the dissenting opinion. Is this your ordinary approach to cases that you have been handling? Because
no,
my opinion is, what controls is the majority decision.
Yes, Your Honor. Uh-huh. No, sir, that's not my usual appreciation.
This is a special one only.
Well, because of the peculiar circumstances.
And there is no other case which you have treated in the same manner, where you laid heavy an emphasis on the dissenting opinion.
There may have been a few.
But you cannot recall anymore.
No more. I was still a practitioner, I believe that the dissenting opinions are...
I'll request permission, Your Honor, to be allowed
had
to...
more put, merit.
It's already 6 o'clock. I do not want to tax...
What is your pleasure?
Your Honor, please. I am sorry.
What is the pleasure of the defense counsel?
I request, Your Honor, that I be allowed to continue with my cross in tomorrow's hearing.
Is there any objection?
And besides, the secretary had been on the witness stand for almost 2 hours.
No objection from the prosecution.
Request granted.
Thank you, Mr. President. Therefore, we will continue
may
with
we respectfully request the Honorable Chief Justice, Secretary of Justice. of the Republic to...
No, no vacancy yet in the office of the Chief Justice.
Yes,
to
Mr. President.
Come back tomorrow to answer questions from the defense.
Yes. Mr. President, may I request that two...